AAMG. Your choice, your health, our mission.
Welcome to AAMG YouTube channel, your health companion. Time flies, now it's October. Some members would like to know more about the nuts and bolts of Medicare benefits because they know now it's open enrollment. They would like to evaluate their existing plans and check and see whether they need to make any changes on the existing coverages. I have invited our very own representative from our member service, Priscilla Guant. She will answer any questions from our community members. Feel free to submit your questions. And currently, I have gotten some questions from members and community friends. So welcome, Priscilla.
Hi, thank you, Esther.
So Priscilla, the first question, some member would like to know, what is Medicare?
So Medicare is a health insurance provided by federal government for people at age 65 and older, or people who are under 65 but with certain disabilities, and you must be a United States citizen or lawfully present in the US.
What are the four parts of Medicare?
So there are four parts of Medicare. The first one, it is Part A, which is for hospital insurance, generally covers inpatient hospital stays, skilled nursing care, hospice care, and limited health home health care services. The second one is called Part B, which is for medical insurance, generally covers medically necessary services like doctor services and tests, outpatient care, home health service, durable medical equipment, and other medical services. And for Part C, which is also called Medicare Advantage, which combines Part A, Part B, and Part D. So what is Part D? Part D is for Medicare prescription drug coverage.
What are the Part A and B sign-up periods?
So you can only sign up for Part B or Part A if you have to buy it during these enrollment periods. So later on, we can talk about why you have to buy Part A. So for the sign-up period, typically there are three enrollment periods that you can sign up. The first one, it is called initial enrollment period. You can first sign up for Part A or Part B during the seventh month that begins 3 months before the month you turn 65, the month that you become 65, and also ends 3 months after the month that you turn 65. The second enrollment period, which is called a special enrollment period, if you didn't sign up for Part B or Part A, if you have to buy it, when you were first eligible because you have group health plan coverage based on your current employment, if then you can sign up for Part A at any time that you are still covered by the group health plan, or during the 8 month period that begins the month after the employment ends or the coverage ends, whichever happens first. You don't have to pay a late enrollment penalty if you sign up during a special enrollment period. And the third one, which is called a general enrollment period. So if you didn't sign up for Part A or Part B, which you have to pay premiums for Part B, during your enrollment and during your initial enrollment period, and if you don't qualify for a special enrollment period, then you can sign up during the general enrollment period, which between January 1st to March 31st of each year. Your coverage won't start until July of that year, and you may have to pay a higher Part A or Part B premium for late enrollment.
So another question is, do I have to work long enough before I can apply Medicare Part A?
So normally you would need to have earned 40 credits or quarters by paying Social Security and Medicare payroll taxes while working. So it equals to about 10 years of work. You will automatically get Part A services without paying premiums. The premiums have already been covered by your payroll taxes. For people who work fewer than 30 quarters, the premium for Part A is projected to be $478 per month in 2021. If you pay Medicare taxes for 30 to 39 quarters, the standard Part A premium in 2020 is 252. So the exact amount for 2021 will be finalized by CMS in later of this year.
The next question is concerning about penalty. There is a member asked, what is the, they heard that there is Part 8 late enrollment penalty. Could you explain a little bit about that?
Mm-hmm. Yes. So if you are eligible for Part A, which is a premium-free Part A, let's say you work for 10 years for the credit, for the quarters, so you will be eligible for the Part A, but you didn't sign up during the initial enrollment period, which I have just mentioned previously, then you will have to pay a monthly premium and the cost will go up 10%. So you will have to pay the higher premium for twice the number of years that you could have had Part A but didn't sign up. So for example, if you were eligible for Part A for 2 years but you didn't sign up, you will have to pay a 10% higher premium for 4 years.
So the next question is how much does Part B cost?
So Medicare Part B has a monthly premium as well. It is projected to be $153.30 in 2021. If you have Medicare Part B and you are receiving Social Security or Railroad Retirement Board benefits, your Medicare Part B premium is usually deducted from your monthly benefits payment. If you are not receiving Social Security or the RRB benefits, there are 5 ways to make your Medicare payment. The first way, you can pay it by check or money order. The second way, you can pay by credit card or debit card. Another way, you can pay through your bank's online bill payment services. Or the fourth way would be signed up for Medicare Easy Pay, a free service that automatically deducts your premium payments from your savings or checking accounts each month. And also, if you get a bill from the Railroad Retirement Board, you can also mail your premium payment over there. So under Medicare, under original Medicare, if the Part A deductible applies, you must pay all costs until you meet the yearly Part B deductible. So for 2020, this year, the deductible cost is $198. So after you meet your deductibles, Medicare begins to pay its share, and you typically pay 20% of the Medicare approved amount of service. There is no yearly limit on what you pay out of pocket. So meaning that there is no maximum out of pocket if you are using original Medicare. And after you pay the yearly deductible, the rest you will be beginning to pay 20% of the cost.
So the next question is, what is Part B late enrollment penalty? We talked about the Part A penalty already.
Yeah, so besides Part A has a penalty, Part B also has a penalty. So if you don't sign up for Part B when you are first eligible, that's like the initial enrollment period that I just mentioned previously, you may have to pay a late enrollment penalty for as long as you have Part B. The monthly Part B premium may go up 10% for each 12-month period that you could have had Part B, but you didn't sign up.
So we talk about A and B. Could you actually explain about what is Part D?
So before we go into Part C, so A, B, and then how come it's not going to talk about C, I would like to talk about D first. So, and then we'll go back to talk about what is Part C. So Part D actually covers Medicare prescription drug. It is available for all people with Medicare. It is run by private companies that contract with Medicare. You pay the plan a monthly premium. They might have deductibles and co-payments, and you can choose a plan to join, and you may pay a lifetime penalty if you join late. There is also a penalty if you didn't join in the right time that you should join. And if you have limited income resources, there is also the Medicare cost extra help to help the Part D cost.
How about any penalty on Part D at all?
Yeah, so the late enrollment penalty is an amount that permanently added to your Medicare drug coverage premium, the Part D premium. There is a period of 63 days when you don't have Medicare drug coverage after your initial enrollment period is over. You will have to pay the penalty for as long as you have Medicare drug coverage. So the calculation is that the penalty is multiplying 1% of the national base beneficiary premium, which is for 2020, right now this year, which is $32.74. And for 2021, it will be becomes $33.06. So you use that to times the number of the full uncovered month that you didn't have Part D coverage. That will becomes your lifelong premium as long as you have the Part D coverage. But also bear in mind that the national base beneficiary premium may change each year. So your penalty amount may also change every year.
I see. Great. So now talk about Part C now. We actually a little this out of order, but I'm sure you can explain what is Part C.
Yeah, so Part C is called Medicare Advantage, which includes Part A, hospital insurance, Part B, medical insurance, and most of the plans also include Part D, the Medicare prescription drug coverage. So Medicare Advantage plans are offered by Medicare-approved private companies. In most cases, you have to use healthcare providers in the plan's network. You will still get those services covered by Part A and Part B, but the Medicare Advantage plans covers those services. Some Medicare Advantage plans offer extra benefits such as vision, dental, or fitness and wellness benefits, which the original Medicare does not cover. You still have to pay the standard Part B premium, and some Medicare Advantage plans might require an additional monthly premiums. And also, the Medicare Advantage plans have a yearly limit on your out-of-pocket costs as well.
So not everyone needs Part C, but certainly there's a lot of benefits to having Part C, right?
So Part C basically including Part A, Part E, and also Part D. So and also some other extra benefits that that original Medicare would not offer. So you could chose to see you could choose to see like which way that you think that would be better for your for what you need.
Okay, sounds good. So could you actually explain what is the C sign up period?
Yeah,
since there's benefit in it.
Yeah. So for Part C, the sign-up period, there are also three enrollment period. The first one is also called initial enrollment period. You can sign up Part C after you have signed up with the original Medicare during the same initial enrollment period. Remember previously we mentioned about the initial enrollment period would start will be a 7 month period of time, 3 months before you turn 65, the month that you become 65, and also ends 3 months after you turn 65. So during this period you sign up original Medicare, and then you can also sign up for Part C Medicare Advantage plan. The second one is called annual enrollment period. You can change for this period of time, you can change your Medicare health plan or drug coverage, including changing to original Medicare or joining or change a different Medicare Advantage plan. The enrollment period would be October 15th to December 7th of each year. So you would be able to choose if you want to join a Medicare Advantage plan, or if you want to go back to a original Medicare, or if you want to change to a different Medicare Advantage plan during this time of period. during this period of time, I mean. So the third enrollment period is called Open Enrollment Period. So if you are already in Medicare Advantage plan, and you can change to a different Medicare Advantage plan or switch back to the original Medicare during this open enrollment period. And the time would be from January 1st to March 31st of each year.
So the next question is, what is the difference between Medicare and Medi-Cal?
So Medicare is health insurance provided by federal government for people who are U.S. citizens or lawfully present in the U.S. Of age 65 and older, or people under 65 with certain disabilities. For Medi-Cal, it is actually provides healthcare coverage to those families with very low income.
Okay, so if I have Medicare, do I really need Medi-Cal at all?
If you qualify for Medi-Cal, Medi-Cal will also cover your Part A and Part B deductibles and co-payments, and also pay for your monthly Part B premiums.
Oh, excellent. Thank you so much for all your time, Priscilla. It's been very helpful. I'm sure a lot of members benefit from this interview. If you have any questions, feel free to write your comments down below, or you have any feedback, and feel free to send it to our email or write a comment below, and or even call our member service, right? What is the number, Priscilla, that you can...
The member service hotline number, which is 415-590-7418. Please call us from Monday to Friday from 8:30 to 5 p.m.
Excellent. So hope we can bring Priscilla on and she can answer any questions that related to our Medicare benefit. Mm-hmm. Thank you for watching. And
thank you.
See you next time.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you for watching this AAMG YouTube channel. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave the comment down below this video. We try to get to your questions or comments. Always remember, subscribe, like, and share this video to your friends and family so more people can be benefited. Thank you for your support.